Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Hybrid Fighting Championships. We've got number one contender matches and group matches, basically. That's our show. We're going to have so many people to go into so many ladder matches.
Canada,
because Christian still technically holds the title, even though
he doesn't.
Here we go. So this match is for entry into a six-man ladder match for the International Championship. Here's Eli Drake, your dummy. Christian using option C to vacate his title and get a shot at Rusev, world champion.
Rusev is not going to crush him, I'm sure. Eli Drake...
He's shiny, isn't he?
Yeah, he's very standard entrance.
Oh!
As we say, he's a very standard entrance when he starts teleporting.
He got in from the opposite side of the ring and then was suddenly at the ramp side of the ring. That was very surprising.
Oh,
he's here.
The stars.
See, this is far more effective in the hybrid arena.
Yes.
It's not daytime. Boom, 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 ba-dum, ba-dum. Bray Wyatt. He's been doing well recently. Let's see if he can get a shot at the International Championship. He's so happy! He's head up in his shoulders, he's like...
Yeah, the camera angle and like his actions are just sort of weird at that situation.
Here comes one of the survivors from the... No, it's not, it's Tyler Breeze. It's Prince Pretty, who is Canadian, I believe.
He's Tyler.
Gorgeous. He's not been put in any silly police uniforms or anything. It's fine. And here comes one of the survivors from the Cruiserweight match at...
He's on fire.
He's smoking. The king of the Cruiserweights. Neville!
Yeah.
Takes a heavy threat to hold his mind now.
Who else? There's two more entrants.
There are two more entrants. So they all get in the ring and then like make space for the next person. What is this? It's blue.
Oh.
Blue? Oh, very dramatic. I think I'm not yet. Yep. It was the dramatic build up to his entrance. The other sole survivor from. You know, that makes sense when you say the other sole survivor, but the other survivor from the Cruiserweight team at
the other
Survivor
Soul
Series.
Survivor.
But here he comes.
3, 4, 5, 6.
The perfect 10. Ty Dillinger.
Woo.
Obviously, the fans are behind Dillinger. Yes. Oh, they've all got their hands up. See, most of that DLC must have just been like the added movement from the crowd.
Probably.
Wow, yeah. That's a lot of names.
Tyler, get off the roof. Yes.
Tyler, Ty, and Eli. Neville going after Ty Dillinger. So we could end up touring in the UK if Neville wins and then wins a ladder match.
I mean, we could. There's all our nationalities here.
There's Canadians, Americans, and I should have put Shinsuke in the match just to make it.
Yes.
Also, Shinsuke would probably have a better shot than Tyler Breeze at this point in his career. Oh, this is new. He beat the AI at this. That's the challenge. Just Guitar Hero up.
Well, we just get a finish from eliminating in the corner.
They can do that, yes. Oh, he's doing squats. He's doing squats with Ty. No, he's doing squats with Tyler.
Tyler.
It's very confusing. We are the TY boys. And not to be confused with TY toys.
Please, Drake. Eli.
Oh, corner elimination. Let's hit the buttons as they appear. Ty Dillinger now going after Bray Wyatt, his rival. And Austin Aries and Neville had an altercation in their Survivor Series match, so the fact that they're fighting is logical. Boom. How many eliminations are there going to be?
Prince
obviously Pretty five,
become King Handsome, or whatever it is.
What?
It's the Battle Royale, and he is the Prince of Pretty. Jesus. Bray Wyatt.
He'll be the King of the Cruiserweights.
You got the Eater of Worlds, or the Perfect
Not
Ten.
Not to mention the Perfect Ten.
I don't know. I'm sure it's all things. You're throwing Bray Wyatt out.
I am throwing Bray Wyatt out. We can't have hybrid.
<off snooze. laughs>
We can't have hybrid tour in parts unknown. Bray Wyatt is gone. That's Ty Dillinger getting a modicum of revenge after all the problems that Neville's eliminating Austin Aries as well. No, nearly. Can't help him. Wanted to help him. Fight you. Oh, Jesus! Oh.
Please, no.
Eli Drake has become a statue. He has suddenly froze.
There's an odd number of people, that's a problem.
That is the problem, Bray Wyatt. Bray Wyatt was the first one eliminated. Some chances of that.
It would almost certainly be Tyler Breeze or
Ty Dillinger.
Ty Dillinger, yeah.
Or Eli Drake, I suppose. It would most certainly be Tyler Breeze.
It'd be first or second, yeah.
Ten. He runs up and then it's just that. Also, it didn't give me a finisher. I've done my signature to you, it didn't give me a finisher. And now Xbox is listening. Xbox, sod off. Boom. I've got my knee pad down. Don't go for my knee. Unsubstitized, that wasn't funny shit. What?
I'm trying to read that, but like, what? It was such like poorly written that it was difficult to like process in my mind. I said, message sent .s to that.
Oh.
Okay, which one? Arbiter. Or Alex Box with top mark?
No, neither, stop it.
Fallen skills.
My batteries are low.
Thank you, Xbox.
Xbox is the surprise interference in this match.
Got to send a message.
I wonder if one of them got a message from you that was just total nonsense. It'd be funny if that eliminated him. And you're doing it as well!
It does at the start of the match. That's what...
I hate this.
Yeah, it's the one that's impossible to do.
It's just mash the buttons.
Oh, you got
him. It depends on your health. My health's not that bad. We're just relaxing up there. Chilling. What God was like. I'm interested to look at the recording and see what that said. That could just be the description of the video. Oh, come on, Ty. Just lay down.
Oh.
No, you can lay down. Oh no. Oh no. Oh, I'm under the rope. Ow, Austin Aries, why? I don't have any, like, it's annoying that they didn't give me a finisher for doing the signature. It really is. They have a second reversal. Eli Drake doesn't. But I do. Oh. And. No. Ty might be done. Ty's done. Ty's gone. No, no more Ty Dillinger.
Yes. Perfect
exit. Austin Aries is now going to eliminate Tyler Breeze.
No. Don't do this to me, Austin, please.
Tyler Breeze could be the surprise victor of this match. Rolling forearm, which is very much an Austin Aries signature. It's performed on him. They're chanting Breeze is gorgeous. My phone is going, probably telling me Skype requires attention. Skype needs your attention. Sometimes it tells me like the messages people have told me, sometimes it just says it needs my attention. Who will win?
This is a finisher.
Is it?
Yeah. No, it's not.
It doesn't look like any of these finishers.
It's a submission, signature, so it looked pretty brutal.
It was annoying that it didn't give me a finisher when I did my signature.
Of course.
Oh, here we go. Chinbreaker. The AI are just fighting in the corner.
Jesus, Austin Aries just ran through me.
I want Eli Drake to win.
Yes.
Eli Drake. I think he's American. Nope.
Oh,
Eli Drake's not one.
No. Neville, please.
Neville.
Oh, God.
It's going to be Neville versus Austin Aries. I panicked. I was hitting the wrong button and everything when it was.
I don't want to go in the corner.
They're both like.
No, no.
The cruiserweight team are coming after Tyler Breeze. Is he going to go last chance over here? I don't think he can in this match, but. Brutal neck twist. I'm going to look up where Legic's from. Eli Drake.
No.
He is from American professional wrestler.
Austin Aries is American, right?
Yes, he's from Milwaukee, Wisconsin. So it's just Neville's. No, we'll get a Canadian and American
well.
And a Englishman all in the ring together. Final three. You know he can do his finisher there as well. Right?
Oh, he's going to just kick me out.
It comes down to the cruiserweights. And we get to finally see who the better man is. Is he going to just kick him out? No, he's going to go for the full animation. Well, is he going to win? Is Austin Aries going to win it? Austin Aries wins it. Austin Aries is going to the match for the international title. Takes a heavy threat to hold his mind down. Austin Aries has been in a winning streak recently.
It's very strong, yes.
First season he did not do well at all, 2K14, Austin Aries not successful. Recently though, Austin Aries has been having a bit of a career resurgence, and now he's in the ladder match for the International Championship. Dude, why is Seth Rollins signed there? Seth Rollins going to run in and randomly attack him like he did to Zack Sabre Jr. in the Cruiserweight Classic. Neville looks so upset. Let's move on to the next match. Group action. Here we go. Group action. with the purple stairs. The guns are back. It's Chris Sabin in Group F, in tag team group. Tag team specialists. He's facing Christian tonight. Let's get him out here.
Yes, Chris Sabin. They won on Fury, I think.
They did win on Fury, yes, you're correct. Oh my.
Oh god.
This is wrong. Here comes Christian with his friend Ed. Ed looks like he's wet himself. His trousers are so shiny.
Oh my.
I've got my title.
What is this?
Oh, I forgot to give Chris Sabin a. Like a moveset, so he's still got the same moves. The title! The ref standing, the title doesn't like being stood on! Come on. Come on, bro. Let's go for that. Oh no, no, Chris Sabin reverses. Christian! I don't know if this match has happened before, surely it has. Christian's still got his t-shirt on. With the bell hand, I could have hit you with the title. You've been great.
Yeah.
Is he going to do the camera cut thing at some point and take Christian's shirt off? He's going to do it at the most inconvenient moment for me, innit?
Of course.
In the middle of a reversal I'm doing.
It's probably not.
Yep. There we go. We went full Brock Lesnar there. Lots of children. Prevented me from ground and pounding for a little while that. A one-on-one match. Christian versus Chris Sabin. So Sabin's already a match down in the tournament. Because he lost Austin Aries.
Yes.
But Christian has yet to face the beast that is Aries. Also, that title's still just floating there. Suddenly, it bounces. It bounces so much. Is there a way I can move it without picking it up? No, can't pick it up. Killswitch in the title would be phenomenal. People love Christian.
Of course.
See that we're just like we're in Canada, so Christian's obviously really popular.
It is Easter soon. Or in the distant past. Must try for Christian.
Yes, Jesus was resurrected thousands of years ago.
Yes.
It's too soon to make those jokes.
Much like
last time Christian was relevant.
Oh, he stood in the title. Oh,
jeez. The title looks so good, it's got a logo on it and everything. The title probably adds to loading times, honestly, being that it's covered in custom logos.
I mean,
and it's flipping about, flopping.
Get that out here. Just
you could pick it up and throw it out.
Got to take the title home.
It's like it's as light as a feather sometimes when you hit it. That was unexpected. That was quite the diversion.
That was brutal, yeah.
Can he hit it?
Probably,
really? It'd be funny if he fell on the title. No, there's no way. It's impossible.
It's not a move that's possible to be hit.
Although the last hybrid that had them in the tag match, there was a lot of them hit.
Yeah, sometimes.
Edge. No, Christian can do it on his own. Christian! You can't even see what's happening. He's wearing sunglasses indoors at night. He has no idea what's going on in the ring. Yes, at TLC, these two have the misfortune of having to go up against the broken!
Brilliance of Matt Hardy.
And Brother Nero. You should have like outside intervention from Senor Benjamin. Senor Benjamin makes an appearance. It'd be great. It was these two that caused the Broken Hardys to be broken in this universe. They attacked them.
Damn them. All broken at Hardy. I broke
the middle, the middle of April they attacked them with the before lockdown. It was literally the 13th of April 2017 it happened.
Literally.
Yes, it was so long ago. If you want to watch back that episode of Hybrid, it's there.
Oh, no. It's a roll.
That was a reversal, but I'll take it. Christian's got a world title match in 2 weeks. He doesn't need to worry about this tournament.
No, he doesn't really know.
Nope, back on the ground now. Just carrying my title back, just so you know it exists. What's his other signature? I've got a suspicion I might know what it is, but... Is it over here? Nope. Oh my. It's unfortunate. Oh, slap! Slap a da bass! It's weird that the ref hasn't taken the title out of the ring though.
Yes. It's
being that he usually takes all weapons and just tosses over.
Maybe because you got it in before the bell rang.
Barely, but still. Did it? Oh my. Christian is busted open! He's busted wide open like a. He's bleeding like a. Something. Bleeding like a stuffed pig.
Tomato.
Just thinking, scalded dog, government meal? No, no, no. Remember your JRisms. Oh, what's happening here? You're just chilling in the corner. You're not doing. You're not quite Tyler Breeze. Christian always gets himself in these hard-fought battles.
No, my signature.
He always wins the matches when they matter.
Oh, I thought I reversed it.
Almost on the title as well.
Please, Mr. Shelley.
I'm trying to get the crowd behind you so you can kick out.
No chance.
Christian! Christian gets 3 points. Chris Sabin is done in the tournament. Like,
no.
He can no longer get enough. Well, I mean, he could.
Yeah.
Hypothetically.
He can only tie for what's set in place and then he would have to.
Yeah, they'd have to be like. He's relying on.
Like a lot of other things.
He's relying on Austin Aries sweeping. Because Austin Aries would have to beat Christian.
Yes.
He's also relying on
Christian.
On John Morrison.
To John Morrison so that they all 3 points.
Yep. He needs
and
Christian.
He has to beat John Morrison as well.
He also has to beat John Morrison himself.
A long way to victory.
All these things that could happen, but they never really do. Oh. Caught and roll up. Maybe if I give him a move set, it'd be better. Probably.
I mean, it's alright, I think. I
totally forgot about that. Totally forgot about that. It was yesterday's show as well. But yes.
DDT9.
Yep. They won with that though. Christian's so happy. He's so excited. Let's move on to the main event. This match is a match for entry into the ladder match for the vacant women's championship at TLC. We've got the Queen,
Miss Charlotte,
the captain from the completely untouched women's team.
Of course.
Total sweep of Team Classic at Survivor Series. So now tonight she's supposed to face Awesome Kong, but Awesome Kong has left the world of Hybrid onto better things.
I see.
So I had to find an appropriate replacement
Did you find anyone?
I did find someone. Someone who is worthy of the hybrid fighting women's championship. But I don't think Charlotte's game plan is going to be ready for it. Maybe a bit of a shock. Here she comes, the Queen versus the Empress of Tomorrow. It is Asuka. Undefeated in WWE and here to make her mark on hybrid. Another person who in the independent scene entered in a German officer's uniform, strangely. But here she comes.
Well, Charlotte, I'm sure, is unfazed.
The Queen. What is better, a Queen or an Empress?
I'm not sure.
Well, let's lock up. We're technical wrestlers, come on.
What is lock? God.
I'll ever do this. Oh, Charlotte is out wrestling Asuka to start with. Ooh. Asuka with the kicks. Those strikes. Her legs are so short. Her attire is also ridiculous because she wears like leopard skin like trunks, but then she wears a thong over them.
Yes.
It's very. Why? Doesn't seem to be in this model, but she does.
Oh, geez.
One of the best strikers in the women's division. Charlotte has no idea how to deal with this.
Run, Charlotte. It's the only way. Pretty much.
Take out a suplex setting. The Empress of Tomorrow.
It's a very long time.
It's disappointing she hasn't made her debut on the main roster. She's one of the best women, probably the best woman in NXT just now. It's probably why she hasn't made her debut. There's nobody to fill her shoes on NXT. And there's Ember Moon, but she's like, she'd be it. She'd be the only one. I think they're trying to make Asuka heel before the debut, but. No reversals on Charlotte. Get her, Asuka! Get her! Oh shit, she had a reversal there. See, that was the problem. Oh my! She's out. Asuka's known as a striker, but that was. These are some strikes from Charlotte. Oh god, it's that weird Neville move. I think Neville rolls all the way over though. Oh, just the big boot. Charlotte is just kicking on the head. Try to concuss the woman in her debut match. Come on, Asuka, you can do it. You're just doing the same move over and over again.
Very nice.
I mean, okay. Whatever you say.
No, my legs does not extend far enough again.
And Charlotte has quite the reach for a female competitor.
She's very long.
She's very long, yes. She appeared in WCW technically. Never as a wrestler, but she did appear in WCW. Remember who her father is?
Yes.
Why the stairs?
She must have appeared very young.
You're not Eric Rowan. What? The trap, it worked excellently.
You're phased by these. Oh god.
Ass first, let's go. Boosh!
The ref though is collateral damage.
He was kind of pushed out of the way, but I wouldn't say it was collateral damage. Oh god! That didn't even phase you.
What was Charlotte's signature?
I think either moonsault. I think it's a moonsault on the big boot.
Oh god!
Yeah, so I have to go Charlotte. Is it on the ropes? Disqualified.
Up the top. bit.
I think it's on a downed opponent as well. Get down, Charlotte. The referee has been knocked whoopy. Mm. Oh my. That would be it. Was that it? No, wasn't it.
That was it.
It was a big boot, but it wasn't the big boot. Ooh, and...
She doesn't have a standing finisher, signature in front. It's disappointing.
Damn you and your bloody finisher reversals.
Thank God.
No. Not the figure eight.
Yes.
Asuka can hold out. Asuka can hold out. Asuka can hold out. Jesus. Charlotte's not even on the ground.
Oh, I thought it's not just pressing it.
Neither of us were paying attention when that opened up. Like the first one, we both totally missed it.
Yeah.
Good thing we ran against AI, that would have been brutal.
Instant blows.
That's an interesting position to do the first drop. Come on. Come on, Charlotte. Come on. No, not Charlotte. Not Charlotte to come on. Not Asuka to come on. Ooh. Asuka has to win. It's her debut. It's expected. She's not Kurt Hawkins or anything. She wins her debut matches. I have no idea what she does from the top rope. Gets reversed, that's what she does. At least she lands on her feet and she doesn't go like splat. This is so close, look at her health and everything.
Oh.
Mm-hmm. Ow. What?
All spinning there.
Jesus. Charlotte has a signature.
Oh.
Jesus. This is a match.
Yeah.
This is one hell of a match. Is it not?
Ah.
Running out. Oh. Kick to the chest. What's our other signatures? Running hip attack and cross arm breaker. Cool.
It's, yeah.
Boom. Asuka, the Empress of Tomorrow. What does Asuka lock target? That's a good question. Because that's the area I should be damaging. You've damaged, like, everything except my arms. It's ground pounder. Grounder and pounder. Luckily that wasn't actually my finisher, I tried to do that. It's gonna keep,
this time, I'm sure.
It's gonna keep getting up. Oh, natural selection.
Of course. Oh, damn.
I used my finisher though. It was so slow, like going round. Come on, Asuka. Come on, Asuka. Come on, Asuka! You need to go up, mate. You need to go up, mate. Reversal! It wasn't quite as fantastic. German suplex. You gave me one earlier, I'm giving you one now. It wasn't quite as dramatic as the one earlier on, but not like Christian's reversal in the last match. One comment I have about Asuka is her English not best.
Let's just speak Japanese.
Yeah, like. The three Japanese stars coming out of NXT, none of them have the best English. They're also all on hybrid, funnily enough. And boom. Get on her. She's got no reversals, get on her. Come on. Ooh. Scott. What's the plan here? I'm just gonna leave the corner anyway. They have any reversals, I don't remember. Tornado DDT. This is a main event.
Yes. Debuting actually.
The Wolfpack's back. What was that? It's the forearm. She is the female Brock Lesnar.
She's feeling good, yes. She's a lot of Charlotte, which is impressive. She's like, I mean, Charlotte is
the top one.
Like, as like a litmus test, is a very difficult one.
Oh, she didn't stay on her feet that time. She didn't roll out of it. GG, Charlotte.
Maybe if she just was like 20 foot taller. Ah.
Here we go.
Whee.
She didn't do the full run up that time. Get a finisher in.
No,
because you don't have a reversal.
That's just natural selection, Charlotte. Oh, God.
Is the queen gonna tap? Is the queen gonna tap?
No.
The queen's gonna tap. The queen's gonna tap. The queen's gonna tap. The queen's not gonna tap. The queen's not gonna tap. It was so promising, bro. She got out of the Asuka lock.
What is? Where can I do her signature? Is it like? Is it spear? Oh, Jesus Christ. There's no point in doing it. I'll try.
They're both Irish whip rebound as well and running.
Oh, that'll do it.
Didn't actually reverse it. No! What's it gonna be? What's it gonna be? Rope break! No.
Oh, no, no. Yes.
Wow, yeah. Asuka is forced to tap. That is unexpected.
Yes. Well done, Charlotte.
Controller must be broken. That must be the the problem. But Charlotte makes it into the women's match at TLC. Asuka, though, her debut was good.
Yes.
She probably should have debuted against it, man. That would have been easier for her.
Someone easier than Charlotte, yeah.
That was like the top match the division could give, and it was given away on hybrid. Although we still have like the possibility of like Asuka versus Sasha Banks or Asuka versus Gail Kim.
Yes. Asuka versus Gail Kim is very Asian.
I mean, Gail Kim's from Canada, so at least it's not like.
Oh, that's. Asuka is actually from Japan, right?
Yes. Osaka, Japan! That is the end of this episode, so leave your ratings and things if you enjoyed. Subscribe to follow the series. And we will see you on Sunday for Cheeky Fatal 4-Way.